Hey everyone, welcome back. Today I am rendering some beef fat so that I can have it for cooking, for deep frying, for just frying in general. I really like beef fat for certain things. And I know that some people are immediately going to start saying, oh, he's rendering tallow. Sort of, maybe, not really. If you take a look, the fat that I've got here still has meat attached. So this is muscle fat. These are trimmings that the butcher has taken off of roasts and steaks and stuff like that. So not technically fully considered tallow. In today's world, tallow sort of has just come to mean rendered beef fat. Traditionally, tallow was only rendered beef fat from internal fat. The fat that lines the inside of the animal and hangs around the kidneys and the liver and that sort of thing. And that fat has no meat associated with it, no musculature in it. And it has a slightly different chemical compound. So at room temperature, it is hard, like really hard. And that's the kind of fat, if you are looking to make soap or candles, or something like that, you want the internal fat. If you are just rendering out fat in order to cook with it, muscle fat is far easier to get and works just as well. There are some people who say that because of the different chemical structure, the internal fat is healthier. I don't know. I don't really, you know, I sort of believe it, but at the same time, I sort of don't. So what I'm doing here is I'm just chopping it up. I'm trimming out as much of the muscle as I possibly can. And you don't need to be terribly fanatical about it. If some of the muscle gets into the pot, it's going to be completely fine. And I know that a lot of the tutorials tell you to put this into... A lot of the tutorials tell you that you have to take all the muscle off. I'm not going to say that because I don't believe it. And most of the tutorials tell you to put it into a food processor and chop it as finely as possible. Again, I think that's a waste of time. Right, so I'm just about there. It's all trimmed up, got it in the pot. Now, at this point, have your oven on preheating. You want a low oven, somewhere between 225 and 250 degrees Fahrenheit. At that temperature, the fat will render out over the course of, depending on how much you've got, 4 or 5 hours. And a lot of tutorials tell you to put water in the bottom of the pot because people are afraid of it burning. If it's burning, your oven is too hot. There's no other way to say it. 225 to 250, and it will not burn. The fat will just render out. And you know, I'm going to put this in and I'm going to check it probably in about an hour and give it a stir. So this is what it looks like after about an hour and a half in the oven. You can see that a lot of fat is already rendered out. Now you could use a scoop and take some of that fat off already if you wanted to scoop it out. I really have no need. I'm just going to let it go probably another hour and a half to 2 hours. So I think this smells absolutely fantastic. Beef fat, wonderful. So the next thing to do is strain it out. Pretty straightforward. Strainer over a big dish and you pour the fat out. Now, that's quite a bit of beef fat. There's probably still more in here. We've been 5 or 6 hours. I might put it back in the oven and see if I can get just a little bit more. This will harden to about the consistency of butter at room temperature. And so you can either keep it at room temperature. My grandmother just kept it in a jar on the counter. Never lasted long enough that it would ever go bad. If you're not going to use it very often, keep it in the fridge. Keep it in the fridge for 5 or 6 months. Or you could freeze it and pretty much keep it a year or more. It'll start to taste bad, but not because it's gone bad, but because it'll start to taste like the freezer. So this is fantastic for French fries. It's fantastic for Yorkshire puddings, all kinds of things. We just did a beef brisket braised in beef fat for tacos. Absolutely amazing. So take a look through the rest of our channel to where we use this. We're going to do a steak frite coming up done in this beef fat. Stay tuned. Thanks for stopping by.